Are you ready for the coming of Jesus? The truth is, this generation knows less about the coming of the Lord than any past generation. This generation is least expectant of the coming of the Lord. It is seldom preached in American pulpits. It's seldom preached anywhere on the face of the earth today that Jesus Christ is coming very soon. I've heard Christians literally mock the message of the anytime return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Literally mock it. The new doctrine is that he is not coming for many thousands of years because he is giving us time to evangelize the world and bring Christ back as king, and then he will come at that time. And this is what is happening now. I see this apathy. Peter said, if in the last days mockers will come with their mockings, following after their own lust and saying, where is the sign of his coming? For ever since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue just as they were from the beginning of creation. But the day of the Lord will come, Peter said, as a thief in the night, into which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with a fervent heat. The earth also and the works therein shall be burned up. Let me tell you why Jesus has not come yet. Let me tell you why he's so patient. It's the same reason that he's not judged America yet, because he is merciful. He's long-suffering. He's not willing that any should perish. I'm amazed at his patience with America, his long-suffering. Right now he's not thinking of judgment, he's thinking of mercy. We're not to look upon the coming of the Lord as a day of vengeance only upon wicked sinners. That's not the focus of the Christian according to the Scripture. The Bible warns you and me that we have enough work on our hands to take care of ourselves. What manner of persons ought you to be in all holy conduct and godliness? Beloved, seeing that ye look for such things, be diligent that you might be found in him in peace without spot and blameless. You and I can sit around and we can look for the signs of the time. We look at Israel for signs of the time. We look at the moral landslide and the signs of the time. We look at headlines and the signs of the time. The Lord says, look in your own heart for the signs of the time. Be sure that you're diligent. Be sure that you are keeping the word of God. Paul said, so then every one of us shall give an account of himself to God. Now you can be sure that God's going to judge the wicked. There's no question about that. The word of the Lord is true. He said the books are going to be open and every man shall be judged out of those things written in the book. And there's a payday coming. There's certainly a payday coming. But God is saying to us, shall not God avenge his own elect which cry night and day unto him, though he bear long with them? He said, I'll do that. I'm going to deal with that. But he said, nevertheless, when I come, will I find faith in the earth? The Lord himself says, will I find faith on the earth when I return, when I come? Here's the greatest concern the Lord has, as far as I see it, when he comes. He's not going to be focused on avengement. He's going to be searching for a people who are walking in faith to expect him. Jesus is coming, the Bible said, for people who look for his appearance. He's coming for a people who are preparing. They're getting their robes spotless through trust and faith in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. They're every day waking up saying, is this the day that the Lord comes? They're not focused on the things of the world. They're not wrapped up in the things of this world. There's a cry in their heart birthed by the Holy Spirit. If there's a cry in my heart, a hunger for the coming of the Lord, what I have in my heart about the coming of the Lord is something that I hear every time I go to prayer now. Every time I seek his face, the Lord says, wean yourself from the things of the world. Don't let the things of this world take your heart. Look up and rejoice because your redemption is drawing nigh. And the closer we get to his coming, the more he's going to awaken our spirits. The more he's going to prepare us in a wooing and drawing through the Holy Spirit. Though we don't know the very moment, the day and the hour. Jesus said of that day and hour knoweth no man. No, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. The Lord could have given us the date. He could have told us the time and the hour. But you know what would have happened. Everybody would have lived like the devil and said, when I'm about 75, I'll repent. Not knowing that they'd be so hard by then, they couldn't repent. The Lord didn't give us time or dates so there would be a holy motivation. A holy motivation, he said, to be ready at any moment, to be expected. He said, I'm coming as a thief in the night. If you won't believe that I'm coming, if you don't prepare, You don't have this ever before you. I hear people say, well, I can't serve God with fear. I'll tell you, I fear missing the coming of the Lord. There's a godly fear in my heart. I don't want to be left behind. But most of all, it's a thrill and it's a joy to know and be with Him face to face. The Lord says, you're going to start drinking with the drunken. This prosperity is going to get a hold of your heart. You're going to be so wrapped up making money. You're so wrapped up in the stock market. You're going to be so wrapped up in possessions. If your possessions are laying hold of you and you sit in the house of God like today, right in the mess of the coming of the Lord, and you're thinking about that car, that furniture, that house, and all the things, and it's got hold of you, consumes you, it pushes out any thought of the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, be careful. You wind up drinking with the drunken. You'll get drunken with furniture, drunken with the things of this life, of building a bank account and all of these things. They're going to grab your heart. And then you don't want Jesus to come because you're so wrapped up. You're so busy doing these things to get security. Oh, folks, in the middle of all that, the scripture says Jesus is going to come. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which some coveted after. They err from the faith. They pierce themselves through with many sorrows. But thou, man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Keep thou this commandment without spot, unrebukable, until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. Are you ready? Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give unto me at that day, but not only to me all, only, but unto all them also that love His appearing. Paul said, I've got a crown waiting for me because I love His appearing. I'm ready. Be patient now. Establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord draweth nigh. James 5:8. And unto them that look for Him shall He appear the second time without sin. God, awaken our hearts. He said, wake up. Wake up, I'm coming. Prepare.